this video, we reconfigure our Start project and add a UART to it. We write some of the basic functions you'll need, put char, put string, check if the UART transmit data register is empty. And then what we do is we add a send flag to our project. So we have some global variables now, so we create a main.h, add that to our project, and then we use the RTC to send our hello world every 500 milliseconds. Let's get going.
Okay, next thing to do is to add a UART to the project, and let's add a hello world. So we're just going to use the COM port on the embedded debugger. And so we're just going to use a transmitter for this terminal in Studio. Defaults are all good, and we don't need anything else. So let's generate the project. So we just added some code there, but that's okay. I'm not going to overwrite those files. Now, in the current version of support for AVR devices, we have an initialization function generated based on our configuration. So let's have a look at UART.c, and there you can see the configuration of the UART, the different registers, and the group configuration of the different bit fields, obviously with comments as well. And here you can see a macro to calculate the baud rate, which will be calculated and at compile time. So we do, however, need to write some of the basic functions like put char and etc. at the moment. So let's write a few of these. UART and the way that we check how to write this is to check UART, and let's look at txdata. So if one opens the data sheet, we can see that the transmit buffer register has a destination of the txdata L. We basically transmit data which is written to that register. So we take in a UART int data, and we send this data to the txdata low register. So checking the data sheet, that you can only transmit when the data register empty flag is set. So basically, we check that the transmit data has been sent. So here we actually return the UART status register and AND it with the flag. Clicking on the flag, we can actually see the define value of 20, but this will be returned true because anything positive is evaluated as true. In the UART put string, we take in a const because the string will never change in the context of the program, and then a string length, which is also a const which I will catch in the debugging. So we test while the UART is not empty. So we first test for a certain condition in our loop, creating an int I, initializing to 0, testing that we haven't reached our string length, and then while not empty, we wait until it's empty, and then we put a char of the next draw of a string. That's our basic function. We haven't made any particular catches. Sometimes you'll have int 8 of many of the framework functions because we use negative numbers for our error codes. So here I'll define our string, hello. And this, we need a define of the length, which is 13 including the new line. So now we can call this from main, UART put string, hello, and then sending the length. It's safer to send a length because then you know for certain that the function will stop sending. And here we've just left off a colon, and we've left off a constant uint8 for the string length. And now if we go tools, data visualizer, and we use a serial port, COM7, it's the same parameters as we set it up for with before, and run the project again, and we get our hello world popping up. Next, what we'd like to do is use the RTC to display hello world every 500 milliseconds. So what we're wanting to do in the driver ISR is create a send flag, which we'll set equal to 1. So this is something that we're going to define in main, volatile uint send flag, and assign it to 0. And because we are defining it here but using it somewhere else, let's create an H file with the reference to this extern, so that we can use the variables in other files. So the way to do this is create add new item, include file, and we're going to use, call it main.h. So it's going to be extern, and what we have created here. Defined again, so in main.c we just need to have a reference to main.h, as we will need in driver ISR.c. Okay. So now we should be able to access send flag, and what we want to do in main is, okay, we don't need the button functionality anymore. So say just if send flag, and then UART put string hello, comma hello len. Send flag equals zero. So if all works well, we should now see hello world every 500 milliseconds. Which was volatile. Let's try again. Now going to our data visualizer, and now you can see that hello world is coming up every 500 milliseconds.